Getting off of hormonal birth control after being on it for 5, 10, or even 20 years can be intimidating. And with a birth control detox, you can avoid or at least reduce some of the side effects like acne or breakouts or mood swings or a return of really painful periods. There are all kinds of things that can happen when you're getting off of birth control. So in today's episode, I'm gonna share with you the four things that you absolutely want to do when you are starting your birth control detox journey. My name is Raven. I am a menstrual health herbalist and combo practitioner. And I have had a pretty rough ride with birth control, to be honest. So what I'm gonna be sharing with you today is from my own experience, but also from working with many people in my practice, with women in my practice. And I just wanna let you know, starting out, that I am not a doctor, okay? I am a menstrual health herbalist. Like I mentioned, my practice is called Moon Medicine, and I help women and people who bleed come into balance with their menstrual cycles, release ancestral and generational trauma, and reconnect to their feminine creative power. And I do that through working with plant medicines, balancing and connecting to the menstrual cycle and the womb space, and working with traditional womb care practices like womb massage and pelvic steaming. So that's my background. Now, I also want to let you know that regardless of where you are in your journey, this is not a video about like bashing birth control. That's not what this is about. Now, of course, everyone has their own experiences with it. I'm going to share with you my experience and also some of the experiences of my clients, but there's no shade coming from me. If you are on birth control, do what's best for you. I was on birth control. I get it. And I also know that for many of us, we're not told about the harmful effects of birth control and how it affects your gut lining, how it affects your mental health, how it can affect your libido, how it can affect all of the systems in your body, not just your reproductive system. Let's go ahead and jump into today's talk because I have so much to share with you. So I was on birth control for about 7 years. I was first put on it, like many people, because of period pain. So this was like a common thing, and it still is a pretty common thing for people to be put on birth control because of menstrual imbalances or acne or something like that, to help stop those things from happening. So I was on birth control for that, and I went through like all of those horrible side effects. Some of the side effects of birth control are headaches, nausea, vomiting, let's see, depression, loss of libido, weight gain, hair loss, all kinds of things can happen when you are on hormonal birth control because this is impacting the endocrine system. For me, I was having loss of libido, I had depression, I had suicidal thoughts, and I just really was missing out on life. I felt so disconnected. I felt disconnected from myself, I felt disconnected from the people around me, I felt disconnected from nature, and I think that was probably one of the hardest things, was feeling disconnected from nature, because for me, that's such a source of grounding, and it's just really important to me. And when I was feeling that, that was around the time that I was starting to realize that maybe this was something that wasn't good for me. I switched to a different pill, and then that next pill that I was on almost caused me to have kidney failure. So at that point I was like, okay, I think it's just time to let go of this because I've just lost so many years of my life to not feeling like myself and just feeling disconnected. And I was angry about that. I was upset. And not only was I on birth control for all those years, but I still had to take painkillers because I still had pain. After being on birth control for 7 years and getting off, I had a lot of womb healing to do. So I went through the process of studying. I studied herbalism, I studied women's health, I studied women's herbalism and ethnobotany, I went to the Yucatan and studied womb massage. I did all of these things to try and heal myself after being on birth control, try and get my cycles back to being normal, because when I started birth control, I had pain like 1 or 2 days a month, and then when I got off birth control, I had pain like 10 days a month, so there was a big transition there, and there was a lot of womb healing for me to do. Birth control acts on the endocrine system, and the endocrine system is a system in our body that basically is in charge of our hormones and our hormonal balance. And our hormones are not limited to reproduction. we have hormones that tell the body when we're stressed. We have hormones that tell our body how to regulate our metabolism, how to regulate things like fat storage and water retention. Like, all of these things are connected to the endocrine system. So when we're talking about a synthetic steroid drug like hormonal birth control that has an impact on the endocrine system, it's important to know that we're going to be impacting all the hormones, not just the ones that are for reproduction. So some people will feel that more than others. Some people will have a lot of side effects, will have a lot of like negative, just negative things happening because of all the other systems that are being impacted. And some people are more tolerant. So it just depends on the person. And there's not really a way to tell like who's gonna experience that. But I think from what I've seen in my practice, people who get put on birth control because of a hormonal imbalance to begin with, whether it be painful periods, missed periods, heavy periods, it can temporarily like lessen the symptoms that people are having, but it can also come with a lot of those side effects. So that's just what I've seen in my practice. Again, I'm not a medical doctor and I'm not here to tell you what to do about birth control. That's going to be your decision. You and your doctor should be deciding on that. I'm just letting you know what I've seen in my practice in women's health and herbalism. So that's how birth control works. It disrupts the endocrine system. It disrupts the communication between the ovaries, thyroid, and hypothalamus, pituitary, all of those glands that are involved in communicating with each other in order to let the body know when to ovulate, when to like produce certain hormones to help keep that cycle going. That is impacted. And when you're on hormonal birth control, you don't have a menstrual cycle. You don't have a period. There's a withdrawal bleed, but you're not cycling. That's what makes it possible for it to work as a contraceptive. One of the other things that you need to know about birth control, about hormonal birth control in particular, is that it has a negative impact on the gut lining. So in the gut, there are these tight junctions, and these are the cells that like hold the lining of the gut together. And when you're on hormonal birth control, those tight junctions start to loosen and there start to be like gaps. So you can see these gaps in between my fingers, and that's allowing food particles to pass from the digestive tract into the body, which causes all kinds of health issues dealing with inflammation and hormonal imbalance, and all of those things are connected to the gut. So that also has an impact on the amount of nutrients we can absorb from our food, what we get from herbs and supplements and all of those things. And that happens regardless of whether or not you are experiencing side effects of birth control. That impact on the gut is kind of like across the board when it comes to hormonal birth control. So when you're getting off of birth control, this is something that I had to find out the hard way. I had no idea this was gonna happen to me. I broke out all over my body. Not just my face, my entire body broke out. And I didn't know what to do. I had no idea what to do. So that's part of the reason why I'm creating this video. That's part of the reason why I created a whole course, a whole 5-week course called Birth Control Detox, to help you avoid those kinds of side effects. Some of the other side effects, aside from acne and breakouts, are mood swings, headaches, and hair loss. All of those things can happen when you're getting off of birth control because you have this endocrine disrupting drug that you're starting to clear from your body. And there's an impact from that. The body is starting to readjust. And then also the body is starting to produce its own natural hormones again. So it's starting to produce its own testosterone, estrogen, and progesterone again. And all of those reactivated hormones can have an impact on how we think, how we feel, our weight, our ability to make decisions, all of those things that birth control can impact can also be impacted by those hormones starting to come back, those natural hormones. So there's that in-between phase when we're detoxing and clearing those synthetic hormones from the body and having our natural hormones come back. So that's kind of where you start to see some of those side effects of getting off of birth control. So what do you do? What steps can you take to start to bring yourself back into balance? Number one, the first thing that you absolutely want to do when you are getting off of hormonal birth control, and you can do this even before you get off, is to learn about the menstrual cycle. study and learn about the menstrual cycle, learn how the menstrual cycle works. This is so important. We need to know what's happening in our bodies. We need to know what hormones are going to be elevated during a certain phase of the cycle. This will let you know what your mood could be, what your energetic capacity could be, and all of those things. Not only that, but I want you to start tracking your cycle. And so you'll need a basal body thermometer. I don't have mine right here. I usually keep it like right underneath my pillow, but anyway, you'll want a basal body thermometer. You take your temperature first thing when you wake up in the morning, before you get out of bed, before you do anything, you take your temperature, and that will go into your app, any kind of cycle tracking app. I like to use Kindara. You can also use a paper tracker and just put everything down on paper if you don't want to use an electronic device first thing in the morning. Then you track your cycle, and this will help you to understand your hormones and your hormonal balance and how things are going, because there's a certain point in your cycle when your temperature raises, and that lets you know that ovulation happened. And this can help you to also plan your life and your activities and start doing cyclical living. Step number one, get to know your menstrual cycle. You can sign up for my course on My Moon. It's free and it lets you know how the menstrual cycle works, what's happening with your hormones, what the different phases are, and what are the energetics of each phase. So use the link in the description for this video and you can sign up for that free class. That's going to be step number one, learn how your menstrual cycle works. This is also important because when you think about the menstrual cycle and think about what you learned about your menstrual cycle, a lot of times most people I know, one, didn't learn about how the cycle works, but also were not really taught great things about the menstrual cycle. A lot of people hold shame around the menstrual cycle, which is totally understandable because when you don't get to learn about this really powerful aspect of yourself and just hide it and, hide your pads, like hide everything that has to do with your menstrual cycle. All that hiding and shame shows up in how we experience our cycles. And if you want to balance your menstrual cycle, if you want to restore fertility, all of those things need to be addressed because we're not just physical beings. You don't just like tell your body, like, turn back on again. You need to like address the emotional aspects and the spiritual aspects of being disconnected from this part of your body, feeling shame around this part of your body. And again, this is something that I have experienced. I didn't learn anything about my menstrual cycle other than like, hey, here's some pads, like this is what you do. And that was basically it. But everything else was hidden. It's so hush-hush and so quiet. Like, it's not the most important thing that we can experience in our lives, or one of the most important things that we can experience in our lives, because our menstrual cycle is what, one, allowed us to be here, our mother's menstrual cycle, and our menstrual cycle makes it possible for us to create the lives that we want and also to create new life. So it's pretty freaking important. It's so important. Okay, so that was step number one. Let me go ahead and move on because I could talk about that for a long time. So step number two, circadian rhythms. You want to do a circadian reset when you are getting off of birth control. So many of us are really out of sync with the natural cycles of light and dark, and those natural cycles of light and dark are in part responsible for our menstrual cycles to begin with. So our circadian rhythms are really, really important for hormonal balance and especially for menstrual balance and fertility. If you have painful periods, you definitely want to make sure that you're doing this circadian reset and making sure that your body is producing enough melatonin, because melatonin is something that plays a huge role in the amount of progesterone that we have. And progesterone is that hormone that helps us to have like healthy cycles, cycles that are not painful, not heavy, and all of those things. So that's really important. To do this circadian reset, basically what you'll want to do is for 6 nights or 7 nights, you will, at night when the sun goes down, no screens, no artificial lights, you just want to have natural light. So you can use candles. You want to make sure that you're not starting fires with this, but find something that's going to work. Make sure that if it's your first night or even second night, just pay attention to the candles and like whatever you're doing to help lower the lighting. And really stick to this, okay? So really stick to no screens. Really stick to this circadian reset. Try and do it for at least 6 nights if you can. And just notice how you feel at night. Maybe start doing some journaling by candlelight and let that be a part of your circadian reset. Another important part of this circadian reset is the fact that you are going to be doing healing when you're sleeping. When we sleep, we're healing. So our sleep is so important for healing the menstrual cycle and getting off of birth control. So that's step number two. Step number three is going to be gut healing. So I mentioned before that hormonal birth control loosens the tight junctions in the gut, and that has an impact on our gut health. So this is so important because the gut has everything to do with every other system in the body, just like the endocrine system. And when our gut health is off, we're going to be experiencing imbalances in other areas of our body. So if you have imbalanced cycles, if you're working on fertility, then you definitely want to work on healing your gut. And one of the ways that you can do that is to spend time outside. When we're outside, we have the sun for one, and then also we have just the natural bacteria that are in our environment, and that helps to support our gut. That's how we can start to repair our gut as well. Now, you can also do a supplement of vitamin D to start out with your gut healing. This can be anywhere between 4,000 to 10,000 IU, and that's going to be a good range for gut healing. Number four, which is going to be nourish. Nourishing your body with herbs, with food, and also with practices are really important. But for now, I want to talk to you about one thing that you can do, which is incorporating herbal infusions. And herbal infusions are more powerful than just a regular herbal tea because they are loaded with nutrients, loaded with vitamins and minerals and nutrients and all those little tiny building blocks that your body needs in order to produce hormones, in order to heal, in order to repair, and basically gives your body like the foundation, the building blocks that you need for optimal health and vitality. So my favorite herbs for infusions are going to be nettles and red raspberry leaf, especially when we're thinking about coming off of birth control and restoring womb health, because red raspberry leaf is an ally for the womb space, for the uterus, and it's an astringent. It helps to tighten tissues. It's also helpful for gut healing in that sense of like tightening the tissues, and it is loaded with minerals. Then we have nettles, an herb that is just loaded with minerals. It's supportive to your blood. It's a blood building herb. So if you have difficult cycles, or if you had difficult menstruation before you started birth control, then you definitely want to incorporate nettles to help give your body what it needs in order to have healthy blood flow, and all of those things. And of course, nettle is going to be great for fertility because, again, you need to get those foundational building blocks in order to have what your body needs in order to create the right hormones. And it's just so deeply nourishing for your whole body. So to make an herbal infusion, you will want to pour 6 tablespoons of your herb into a quart jar, and then fill that jar with hot water. And you'll do this at nighttime because that will help you have a longer infusion. You can do at least 4 hours to overnight. So if you start it at night, great, you strain it off in the morning and you drink it that next day. And if you don't start it at night and you want to still get that infusion for your day, then start it early in the morning and let it steep for at least 4 hours and then drink it. So that is the nourish aspect of the birth control detox. Again, this is just the beginning. These are just the first steps. So there's a lot more to this. There's herbs, there's diet, there's practices for healing the womb space, there's practices for healing after having IUD and helping the body to heal after scarring from an IUD. And all of these things are in my birth control detox course, and you can join me. I do this live, and we have 5 weeks together to dive into coming back into balance, having a healthy menstrual cycle, restoring your fertility, and also starting on the path of connecting with your creative power, because your menstrual cycle is the seat and your womb space is the seat of your creativity. And if you're wanting to work on fertility and just feel connected to yourself again after being on birth control, and you want to find balance, you want to avoid those side effects, you want to have a healthy menstrual cycle, and you want to know all the steps to take in a very holistic and natural way, then definitely join me for that. You'll find the link in the description for this video. I hope to see you there, but that's basically it for today. I hope you enjoyed learning about my birth control detox, and I look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye.